If you've been paying even a little attention to the news lately, you've probably heard that things aren't looking great for science in the US right now. But there's one particular weird piece of extra damage that you might not have considered. Hi, I'm David, and let me back up a bit. The US government pays for almost half of the basic science research done in the United States. But the current administration is threatening to shut down pretty much all funding for science-related grants. In fact, it already briefly halted that funding earlier. This is obviously bad news for science itself. Government-funded research is how we know much of what we understand about the world, from epiphytes to epicenters to epidemics. Even research into a seemingly ridiculous subject like rat massage has saved thousands of lives and hundreds of millions of dollars. It's true, we made a video about it. Cutting funding means all of this work would come to a grinding halt. If you're a science lover, you've probably already thought about this. But there's another less obvious consequence of cutting science funding. You might not be able to learn about science on YouTube, which is admittedly not nearly as big of a deal. But because you're here watching this video, I'm going to assume that you are one of the hundreds of millions of people who benefit from science content on this platform. And here's the thing, many of your favorite channels rely, at least in part, on the kind of funding that's in danger. Here at MinuteEarth, half of our production budget last year came from partnerships with scientists at government organizations like NASA and through government-funded universities and National Science Foundation grants. These institutions allocate a tiny piece of their budgets to outreach and communication about science, which includes supporting editorially independent videos on channels like ours, so we can share the important and awesome research they are doing with curious folks around the globe. And for us, this money is critical because the ad revenue we get from people watching our videos, even though a lot of people watch our videos, isn't enough to actually cover the hundreds of hours it takes to make each one of them. The economics are similar for a lot of your other favorite science YouTube channels. The bottom line here is that good, trustworthy science communication is at risk. But unlike a lot of other big problems out there, there are things that you, yes, you, can do to help both science and science YouTube, no matter where in the world you live. First, make your voice heard. There's a lot of evidence that the government lifted its initial research funding stoppage because of the huge reaction from folks like you. And second, there is still research happening and science to explain. So find the Patreon of your favorite science communicator and directly support their work, so they don't need to rely on the whims of government funding to continue telling great science stories. We're gonna list a bunch of them in the description, and please add others in the comments. Together, we can make sure really good educational science content sticks around.